Hey, you call the meeting to order. Welcome to our city commission meeting. Looks like our minister is not here, so we're going to have Rep. Nevin lead us in prayer, followed by the pledge led by General Queen. Please rise.
Let us pray. Father, we just thank you for today. We thank you for this opportunity once again to exercise the authority you have delegated to this body and to other political bodies throughout this nation. And we're hopeful and pray that wisdom will be displayed today. And thank you for this community and the wonderful resilience it has displayed over the last 2.5 years. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Please join me in the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Randy, would you call the roll?
Mayor Brennicki.
Here.
Commissioner Street.
Here.
Commissioner Halagus will not be here today. Commissioner Brown.
Here.
Commissioner Rader.
Here. Commissioners, we've got the minutes from June 8th. We're going to have a chance to read those minutes. Any additions or deletions? If not, entertain a motion to approve the minutes as presented.
Good morning, Mayor.
Good morning, sir.
I read the minutes pretty thoroughly. I didn't see anything that was wrong, so I'd like to move approval of the City Commission minutes from the meeting of June the 8th, 2021.
Second the motion, Mayor.
Call the roll.
Commissioner Street.
Yes.
Commissioner Brown.
Yes.
Commissioner Rader.
Yes.
Mayor Brennicki.
Yes. We have upcoming appointments to the Downtown Improvement Board. The term of Catherine Shores expires on August 14th, and she wishes to remain on the board and does not require a unanimous consent at this time. Term of Nick Benintani is expiring on September 1st. He does not wish to remain on the board and does not require unanimous consent at this time. These are appointments that I make, so if you are interested, please see Brandy at City Hall and let us know, fill out an application. Next, we've got a couple of announcements. June 25th, our Quality of Life Department is bringing Anthony Peoples Trio to K Park on June 25th as part of our three-part summer concert series, Music by the Bay. The event kicks off at 7:30 and wraps up at 9, so bring your lawn chairs. And if you have never heard Anthony play, he is outstanding.
He does a good show.
What kind of music you like, he is a talented dude, and so are his counterparts. July the 4th, 2021, make plans to join us downtown July 4th for the city teams up with Destination Panama City to present a salute to freedom. Kickoff starts at 5. With a parade downtown, followed by live music from Son of Saints and Loud Planet, and ending with fireworks at 9:30. We'll have vendors, a kids zone, and lots of fun. So let's pray for good weather.
Yes.
It's raining outside and all this wind we've had the last few days, it made me think, just like it made my dog think, about the storms. He goes and hides every time now with, you know, when we have any kind of thunder and lightning and all this stuff. And so I go back and I reflect on all the different things that we've been going through since the storm, the COVID, you know, stoppage of work, wearing the masks. Do you wear the mask? Do you not wear the mask? And the resiliency that was really, really tested by all our people working in the city. There was one particular person who had to go through, and I'm going to single her out today because it's one thing to wear a hat or two hats and have to deal with so many things out of the ordinary, plus still have a family and all that stuff. This person wore three hats and had to step into doing a position that she was kind of familiar with, but, you know, not totally familiar with it, and she did a tremendous job. So today, I want to present a plaque. Miss Brandy Waldron, would you come down here, please? We're going to need a little scratch and dent on the... In recognition and appreciation of service, the interim city clerk treasurer from 1/14/2020 to 6/30/2021. And I'll tell you, this is something to remind us, something to remind you, but I wish that I could put the amount of money, if this was a block of gold, it would probably be more worthy to give to you, but thank you so much. Never complains, never belly aches. I wish I could be more like her. And just gets the job done. And from me, from all the rest of the commissioners,
yes.
Thank you. We love you.
Mayor, if you're ever having a down day and you want to smile, just talk to Brandy and you'll be smiling pretty quick. She, it won't come much better.
Thank you, and I could not have done it without the amazing staff that works for the city clerk's office and the team of teams, and thank you all for the opportunity. It's been wonderful. Thank you.
Welcome.
Brandy, how old were you when you started with the city?
17.
That's right. That's a lot of faith. You've done a great job.
How about attitude?
You're staying with us, dude.
Yeah.
That's right. She ain't leaving.
Okay. At this time, we'll have audience participation. If there's something that's not on the agenda today you'd like to discuss with the commission, do so at this time. Give your name and address, please.
Addressing items in the packet that I left yesterday. Okay, this is a request for the city commissioners to ask Bay Transit to rescind their plans to terminate public transportation for downtown Panama City and the marina. This is a bad idea for both the city and the people who use public transportation, mainly the number 4 bus that goes south and north from 11th and Harrison, the intersection. I was going to read, this is very good, the statement you have is very good synopsis of the general problem of transportation, how it affects the city and the citizens. But yesterday I experienced a real situation involving real people who this is going to affect negatively. I took the bus down from 11th, right across the street here, and Wood, across the street from the library, down to 11th and Harrison, and made a right, and we went down to the city downtown. People could access City Hall, post office, and their jobs. When I was on the bus, there was 7 of us. Hmm. It was raining. If this plan is implemented, we couldn't have gone downtown. We would have had to get off at 11th and Harrison and walk in the rain down to City Hall, down to the post office. And this does not include people in wheelchairs, disabilities. One lady had a walker yesterday, and she would have had to walk in the rain. So it is very brutal what Bay Transit expects the citizens to go through for their plan. Now, here's the other end of it. Okay, so if you don't get off the bus, this is what Bay Transit wants you to do. Now, do you all have your maps? Okay.
Yeah, I looked at it.
They want you, I'll do this real quick. They want you to stay on the bus, go all the way to Callaway on number 4, 15 miles, get off in Callaway, wait for the number 2 bus in Callaway, and come back 15 miles to the city, to the marina, but it drops you off at 4th and Harrison. Then you gotta walk another block up to 5th. This is 2 hours of wasted time, and this should not happen. I appreciate your
Thank
listening.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you for bringing that to our attention.
Wait for him.
Good morning. We honor our mayor and then commissioners. Thank God for you. We still
Mr.
have.
Mr. Henry, you got to put your name into the record. You know
Walter,
that.
Walter, you're going to start me off. Walter P. Henry, 614 Maple Avenue, Panama City. I don't know if you go back or what, but you already started. We spoke before, and we said that we keep doing things in the like neighborhoods that we would not do in other neighborhoods. Well, I don't know if we're the one that y'all think we are complaining, but I guarantee you, if you set these things over in the cold, even one, the cold go open their mouth, they're going to speak. If you set one in Benicia and Villa, those folks are going to speak. We have a right to speak. If you took another one and set it in Millville and around 3rd Street, Main Avenue, either 3rd and Maple, those people will complain. They're not here. It's not, they don't have the problem. So they're not saying anything. And I know that y'all probably say, we get tired of hearing them. If you get tired of hearing us, do something, hear us, and do something about it. You know, yes, but we all saying, I think if we were Christian, like we said, we would have a heart for everyone, not just a heart for ourselves. Sometimes we do things, we say we're doing it for the people, but most of the time we're doing it for how we feel or how we think. Never think about how do the people think of the city about it. So if you just take one, try it, put it over there on Benicia Villa or King's Point, I guarantee you this building will get full. It'll be more than us talking. And I know you might hear them better than you hear us, but you know, we're going to continue to cry until somebody hears what we're crying about. Now, Christians, I don't care what you are, what church you go to, if you got a heart of God, you will do better than what you are really doing.
Mayor, Rufus Wood, 1911 East 10th Street, to Mr. Mayor and to the commissioners. I wanted to follow up with what Pastor Henry is referring to, and that is the transitional houses slash some people call storage sheds, which have been placed in the Glenwood community around the 9th Court area. We're very much concerned about that. I attended a meeting Friday at City Hall with Ms. Janice Lucas and Mrs. Donna Pilson. Mr. Johnson, Michael Johnson was present at that meeting. We had several people from the community who were present at that meeting. And most of the people at that meeting were not very happy with what has happened in Glenwood. We want you to know that we are not opposed to helping homeless people. I understand the scriptures quite well. I've studied it for many, many years. Jesus said that we are to take the strangers in. There's no question about that. My congregation has done that for the past 30-plus years. So we've been engaged in doing that. I think the critical question is, for the community, is this really the best way to help the homeless people? Dr. Maya Angelou once said, people will forget what you say, they will forget what you do, but they will not forget how you make them feel. And right now, Glenwood is not feeling very good. Glenwood is feeling that they're being disrespected. That came up at the meeting on Friday. I talked about respect at the last commission meeting. The community feels that they're being disrespected because they were not informed about the project. There was no input from the community regarding the project. We already were dealing with this issue with the shotgun houses in our community. The community is feeling that this is going to lower their property taxes, so they're very much concerned about that. And then the timing of the project, how long is this going to be there? Mr. Johnson assured us that October would be the end date. Mrs. Pilsen said she would gladly ask for additional time. So we don't know how long this will be in our community, and we're very much concerned about that. I follow up with what Pastor Henry said. Now, if this is such a desirable project, and if it's so wonderful, there's a brother that stands on the street and says, let's spread the love. So if we really care about the homeless people and the city wants to do this, let's spread the love. Let's put some downtown. Let's put some in the Cove area. Let's put some in St. Andrews. Let's put some in Millville. Let's put some at Kings Point if it's such a wonderful project. I don't think Glenwood should be the community to test everything. Let's test it all over Panama City and see how well does it work. I go to my seat with the words of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., who said, we must learn to live together as brothers and sisters, or else we will perish together as fools. So we're asking you all to please take this into consideration. And then finally, the community really would like to hear from our commissioner that represents the Glenwood community. And I know Commissioner Brown often says he does not only represent Glenwood, he represents other areas in Ward 2. But Glenwood is a part of that ward.
Thank
so they
you.
Would like
Thank
to hear.
You, Rufus. Okay.
Well, you didn't cut the other people off. You
yeah.
didn't cut the other people off. So let me finish my statement, please, sir. Let me finish my statement. You gave the other man additional time.
I did not.
Let me finish my statement, Mr. Mayor, please.
Go ahead.
We're asking for the commissioner, since he has been on mute and we have not heard from him. The community is asking to hear from the commissioner that represents that ward, because that is part of his responsibility to be concerned about the needs of the people in the Glenwood community. Thank you.
Thank you. Mayor, I would like to just say, you know, I'm going to back up to Mr. Henry. He's a good friend of mine. I thank the world of him. And he worked for the city for many, many years, and he knows a lot about infrastructure and where pipes are laid, and I have to hand it to him for that. But I'm not quite sure, Walter, and please forgive me, what exactly it is that you're requesting for us to listen to or to show action to. I mean, I hear you, okay?
So, well, let's ask Mr. McQueen.
Yeah, and maybe
Are you familiar with what they're even talking about?
I understand what Dr. Wood is talking about. I do not understand what Mr.
So if you'll explain that, it would help.
Same thing I'm talking about.
Okay.
Yeah. That's all I'm trying to say.
Okay, well, what?
I don't want to be in the dark here, you know. It's a gray area.
We do have that.
Okay. All right.
So, Walter, thank you. You know I love you in Christ.
We got it.
You know that.
Okay. As long as he knows God. Yeah, I didn't.
They'll just talk to me.
This is what we're here for, to get answers.
But tell me what it
is. To understand. Well, I'm just saying, if these things, as Ellerwood, Bishop Wood said, if these things are so wonderful, you know, they look so good, why are we not just putting them in one area? And I'm not talking about putting them all in the black area, if you put some over in St. Andrews on that main church, somebody go cry out.
Okay, we got it. Go ahead, Mr. McQueen, tell me what we're talking about.
Yeah, so over in, as part of our effort to try to meet an immediate
You can sit down, Mr. Henry. We got it.
Thank you, Walter.
Go ahead, thank you.
As part of our effort to try to meet an immediate need of some homeless local individuals who have found themselves to be homeless, we had an opportunity to use some modular homes that were available to us through Habitat for Humanity. They donated one to us, and they sold us two additional units. Those units are being established over at Glenwood. This commission took action to suspend trailers and motorhomes and those types of things in properties through the 10th of October of this year. That is the case for these modulars, that they are going to be there until the 10th of October of this year, and then they will be removed. This is just a stopgap measure to assist with individuals who have found themselves without homes. We had one lady who, with two children that were in a living in her vehicle, and lived over and was in the Glenwood community. And this was a way that we could assist to meet the needs of our own homeless within the city of Panama City. It is a temporary measure. It's an expedient measure, and it will be removed by the 10th of October.
Okay. Thank you, Mark. Mm-hmm.
Can I ask a question? I didn't know about this particular project until I became aware of it because it hit social media. So that's how I became aware of it. I do want to know, I know you made mention that we've used the allowing of mobile homes and things like that. Did this project go through the permitting project that we just went through?
That's my understanding it did.
Okay. Yes. It would probably be good, just from a community communication standpoint, that we get that posted just like we have our citizens do, so that the community would know when something like this happens that it is a temporary project and that it's something that's not going to stay, because there seems like there's a lot of miscommunication that's going on. I wasn't aware of it until social media. I don't think anybody on this panel was aware, and so I apologize. So that there was obviously some communication that was misstepped here. And so, but I mean, we do want to help the homeless population, and I understand your point. And personally, just speaking from Ward 4, if this is something that we need to address in every ward to make everyone feel like it's a fair representation, I would be happy to champion that.
And how many trailers are we talking about?
Three.
Three trailers?
I was actually kind of jealous at first because I saw a container home project going in and it wasn't in my ward. And so, and then I found out what the full thing was. Okay. So for just reference, I'm for container homes and that kind of thing. But I do think there was a lot of communication that just did not go well here. And so if we can get that posted, get that permit that you sent, Mark, and let the residents know exactly when that is going to expire.
But it expires the 10th. That's
yeah, three temporary census. Trailers till yep. October the 10th. Okay, I wasn't aware either. Mm-hmm. All right.
Good morning, Council.
Morning.
Edward Bell, 720 Kirkland Avenue, Panama City, Florida. First of all, Mr. Sims, today would be a good day to go out in the Mirville area and see the drainage. My property is teetotally secured. Water flowing from the back, going down to the drains. The second thing, I don't want to follow, I was at that meeting Friday about the storage containers, but what I want to address today is, let's go back to about a couple of months ago. Let's go to Daffin Park, and let's go to Carl Gray Park. I was at the Carl Gray Park yesterday. I did a little bit of research on Carl Gray Park, where on the first phase, you know, spent $500,000 of the $800,000 that was received from BP. Now the second phase is, hopefully that will be putting the benches back in there, the accommodations for the public. The reason Carl Gray Park is so influential to me, Carl is from Millville. His family is buried over in Millville. Now, let's just say the Afro-American groups, from when we would come down from Mariana, we would have picnics out there. You would get to the table, the first person gets to the table for the 4th of July weekend. We didn't have to go through the city for nothing. It's an excellent place for when you bring kids, the water is shallow. Now, you can dredge it out for boats, you know, but now, Not too many people I know or I communicate with have them big boats to launch out there that can get to West Bay, that can go to the beach, that can go around and accommodate Cargray Park. So let's diversify the use in that second phase of Cargray Park. In 2011, I got a minute and a half. While I was over at the Salvation Army, I put an excellent fundraiser line there. With the pandemic out here, you can have the kids playing, the parents supervising the kids, family members coming in. You can put a blood mobile out there. You can have vaccinations. You can have political events that will come in when people are politicking together. You can look over at the port. It's a perfect example to show the kids the School of Gulf Coast, Florida State. If you need a lifeguard, you might can go over to Florida State and get one of the people that's majoring in their aquatic program. I mean, and then you and Ben was on where the county and the city is communicating with the different funds that's received. Let's deal with Cargray Park. Let's go down to Daffin Park. Let's spend some of them funds down there to attract the inner city kids and the youth. The families, the attraction, and at Cargray Park, you can get some of that beach traffic. You can get some of that revenue from over there. Some of the people that fly in from the beach, you know, it's not that many things going on to accommodate everybody on the beach. If they find out something's going on at Cargray Park, they'll come over and spend revenue. It's an excellent place where you can sit there on the bench, read your Bible. I can understand if at night the police department scan the area. You got FSU Police Department, you got Panama City Police Department, you got Bay County right across the bridge. If something happens there, we got perfect resources to secure that environment. Let's not let that part go away and then maybe one day when we're not paying attention to it, a big nice condominium coming there, you already done spent millions of dollars for the boat ramp, and then we won't have access to the property. And basically, I'm interested to see what we're going to do with the park design and where the old Tico Gas place was going to be once we start that development of affordable living down there. Thank you.
Just for the record, thank you for speaking, Edward. I think it's been probably, gosh, 7-8 years ago, a Gulf Coast Community College, at the time they were not a state college, came to us, and gosh, we all support them and we love them, and they wanted us to donate that park to them, but we did not do that. That park belongs to the citizens. So we took a stand that is our park, and if there are additional improvements, if there's money anywhere,
there is, then we
need to do it, you know. So I appreciate you bringing it to our attention. I don't own a boat anymore, but I do know that there are people that complain about not enough boat places, so that is as important to folks for that. So that's just me, you know. I'm with you on what you're saying, though. So thank you, Edward.
Good morning.
Morning.
David Smith, 1070 East Caroline Boulevard, Panama City. First, I want to thank you all for the service that you do. It's very commendable that what the commission and the city manager and his staff do to move this city ahead and to put it on the path to become the premier city in the Northwest Florida. Upcoming on that path is new zoning regulations. And next month, you'll be urged to vote on those new zoning regulations. And one thing in particular on those new zoning regulations I ask you to look at is setback rules. Dover Cole did an amazing job of planning a strategic vision for this city and for putting together articles after articles, documentation to help us get there. But I ask you to look at their setback rules because in the neighborhood downtowns, there's a maximum of 10 feet. 10 feet maximum setback. And what does 10 feet mean in neighborhood downtowns? Let me use St. Andrews as an example. 10 feet, a 10 feet maximum means that people can't gather outside of a Hunt's Oyster Bar as they do today. A 10 foot maximum means that merchants can't display their wares as Sunjammers and Floriopolis do today out in front of their business. 10 feet means that you can't have outdoor dining in front of your building as Amavita Coffee Shop does today. So I ask you, as these come up, please look carefully at the setback requirements and consider, is that 10 foot maximum reasonable, practical, and does it make those districts walkable, or does having a little more help improve the walkability of those districts? Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Mark, you might be able to answer this, but I think in the Dover Cole plan with 10-foot setbacks maximum, I think that also accommodates for outside seating counts towards that 10-foot setback. So it's not that the building has to go all the way to 10 feet. It's the actual development that goes that far. So Hunt's Orchard Bar would comply, so would Amavita, and so forth.
Can I rebut that? Thank you, Mr. Street. Yes, if you look carefully, yes, you can have the 10-foot setback, but you have to have 100% impervious service area. And so Hunt's, which actually has a little bit of dirt out front, would not be... It's not quite the same. You mean you've got to be impervious means no water can penetrate.
I'm happy to have an offline conversation with you if you want to wait and time for me. I'd love to. The impervious is what's allowable. It's not that you have to put in 100% impervious surface. Thank you so much.
Okay, we'll go on. Devin?
Thank you. The first item is ratification of extensions to the declaration of state emergency due to Hurricane Sally. Request approval of the extensions.
Hear a motion on extension 39 and 40.
Yes, Mayor, I'll move approval of extensions 39 and 40.
Second motion, Mayor.
Discussion, call the roll.
Commissioner Street?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Mayor Brennicki?
Yes.
Next item is request for approval of extensions for state of emergency for COVID-19 is extensions 65 and 66.
Your motion?
So moved, Mayor.
Second motion, Mayor.
Discussion. Call the roll.
Commissioner Street?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Mayor Brennicki?
Yes.
The next item is to consider a resolution to support Bay County Economic Development Alliance and its Project Juniper efforts. Becca Harden is here in the audience and she will present this, but she will be requesting support for a new retail business.
Good morning, Mr. Mayor and members of the commission. Proud to be in front of you today. This is a non-traditional project that we're bringing to you today. It's not what we normally would bring to you, but we're really excited to be able to support this project because of the very positive impact that this project will have in the northern part of the city. As Mr. Zimmerman mentioned, this is a retail-oriented project that will create over 200 jobs over the next 3 to 5 year period. From an ad valorem tax standpoint, this project will pay the city more than $300,000 per year in new taxes to the city, and also pay over $250,000 per year in new merchant taxes to the city. Part of this development will also build important connector road off of 231 and 390. So the incentives that the Bay EDA is asking for support for this project today is an investment of the collected merchant tax on this project by the city back to the developers to make the Project Juniper financially feasible to go forward, and that is estimated at $2.8 million. And then the support payment of cost of the connector road with Bay County and the City of Panama City at an estimated $3.3 million. And we ask for your consideration to support this very important Project Juniper.
Just as further explanation very quickly as far as the background for what the City Commission has done in the past, it is mentioned in the resolution, but back in 2016, the Commission actually had a discussion about investing new money, merchant tax money, into a project if it would relocate as an incentive, and you did so in 2017. The Bay City Point project came in. It presented that it could not come without some assistance. It's called the financial feasibility gap. And the city approved investing 90% of all new money that's generated on the project to encourage that developer to come in. And there's a cap. In that case, phase one, I think, was $9 million. The city moved ahead, the developers moved ahead, and that project exists today. So this is similar to that. not as robust, not as big as Bay City Point as far as the merchant tax. Then also the additional item here is a road. It's a connector road that would be used not just for the project, but would be used by the entire community. And they're requesting the city to contribute toward that connector road. This is not a binding commitment. However, this is a commitment that the developers will use in attracting the important tenants that they need to make this project come about. So it's a good faith effort, and the city, if you were to adopt this, that you are agreeing in good faith that if the tenants can be attracted, that you will sit down and negotiate agreements along these lines.
Hey, Becca, could I ask a few questions, Ms. Harden? So it sounds like we're getting a new road. That's one. We're 200 jobs and about $300,000 in new revenue once we've essentially paid this back. So that sounds like a fairly pretty good deal. So
yeah,
if it doesn't happen, how much do we pay?
Nothing.
Okay.
You know, my motto is nothing from nothing is nothing.
All right. So if it doesn't happen.
No upfront money.
Yeah.
Nothing.
No upfront.
Thank
money.
You.
There you go. Good question.
And 200 jobs that pay above the average wage of the county.
Great. Thank you.
Any other comments?
Yes, Mr. Mayor. When we first started this project on Bay City Point, which I usually call the Hawkins property, we went through some things on it, and we had to make a decision to go for it because my deal was most of what we are looking for is to bring jobs toward the community, and it is so close to the Glenwood community that we are a walkability-type area. Mm-hmm. And if anybody looking for a job at Bay City Point, they could walk to it. That's something that the Glenwood community have always walked to downtown, walked to the mall, and now we're still walking, if we choose to the Bay Center Point. So if there's no objection at this time, I would like to make a recommendation of approval.
Hear a motion, hear a second?
I'll second.
Any other discussion? Call the roll.
Commissioner Street?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Mayor Brunicki?
Yes. Thank you, Becca.
Thank you,
I'd like to read the title. Resolution number 2021-06-22.4, a resolution of intent of the City of Panama City to support the Bay Economic Development Alliance in its efforts to bring a retail sales company known as Project Juniper to the City of Panama City. The next item is a request to approve resolution number 2021-06-22.2. It's related to a First Amendment to a joint participation agreement with the state of Florida. We already have a contract for $200,000 to provide landscaping services that DOT pays the city. I'd like to increase that by another $50,000. Recommendation is to accept that amendment.
Your motion?
Yes, I'd like to move approval of that, Mayor.
Second the motion, Mayor.
Discussion. Call roll.
Commissioner Street?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Mayor Brunicki?
Yes.
Yes, thank you. Resolution number 2021-06-22.2, a resolution of the City Commission of the City of the First Amendment to joint participation agreement between the State of Florida Department of Transportation and the City of Panama City, Florida, to provide additional funding in the amount of $50,000 for a financial project as set forth below.
Thank you, FDOT.
We also have a budget resolution on that same item.
And you adopted two resolutions. And the budget resolution is resolution 2021-06-22.3, a resolution providing for the amendment of the approved fiscal year 2021 budget for a Florida Department of Transportation beautification grant. And I'd just like to say that, Brandy, will you still be here to prompt me?
From the first row.
Thank
yes.
you. The next item is to request an executive session pursuant to Florida law to discuss and receive advice regarding the opiate litigation that the City of Panama City is involved in. Mr. Cliff Higbee is your special counsel to the city, and he has requested this. It would be Tuesday, June
It's
July 13th.
It's
July 13th.
Yeah, that's the wrong. Oh, no, I'm requesting it today, but it'll be on Tuesday, July 13th at the end of the city commission meeting. Those in attendance will be the five city commissioners, your attorneys, and the city manager and a court reporter. So request approval of having that executive session at the next meeting.
Your motion?
Yes, I'd like to move approval, but I have a question. Are we having a CDC meeting that same day? Right after the commission? Is that a conflict?
I don't know.
I mean.
Yes.
Okay. I just thought I'd read that. But I would like approval of it. Surely we can work around these things.
Yeah.
Second the motion, Mayor.
Okay. Discussion? Call the roll.
Commissioner Street?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Mayor Brunecki?
Yes.
Mr. Mayor and Commissioners, I invite your attention to Section 7, Unfinished Business. We have a number of final readings for your consideration. At this time, I would ask that items 7A, 7B, and 7C, all related to the Morningside development, that we delay and reschedule this meeting for a date certain on the 27th of July, 2021.
Okay. Motion to delay 7A, B, and C till, when did you say?
July 27th.
July 27th.
I'll make the motion.
Yep. Okay.
Second motion.
All right. Any other discussion? Call the roll.
Commissioner Street?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Mayor Brunecki?
Yes, ma'am.
Item 7D is final reading of Ordinance 3000.1, voluntary annexation of 0.526 acres of property located at 3037 West 30th Court in Panama City, Florida. The applicant is requesting annexation, land use change, and rezoning in order to access city services. The Planning Board considered this item at its regularly scheduled meeting on May 10th, 2021, and the motion was made to recommend approval, and it was done so unanimously. As such, it's a recommendation that we conduct the final reading of the request for annexation.
This is a public hearing. Anyone like to address us? Seeing no one, to hear a motion.
I'll make a motion.
Second the motion, Mayor.
Okay. Any discussion? Call the roll.
Commissioner Street?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Mayor Brunecki?
Yes.
Thank you. The city has adopted ordinance number 3000.1 and an ordinance of the city approving the voluntary annexation of 0.526 acres of unincorporated property located at 3037 West 30th Court, Bay County, Florida, into the city as further defined, amending the wards and boundaries of the city to include said land and providing an effective date.
Item 7E is final reading of Ordinance 3000.2, amending the future land use map of the city to reflect a land use designation of residential for Panama City for the property located at 3037 West 30th Court, Panama City, Florida. It's the same information as I shared with you earlier in the annexation agenda request, and the recommendation is to conduct the final reading of the ordinance.
Continuing the public hearing, anyone like to address us? Seeing no one, hear a motion on 3000.2.
Make the motion.
Second motion, Mayor.
Discussion? Call the roll.
Commissioner Street?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Mayor Brunecki?
Yes.
Commission has adopted Ordinance 3000.2, an ordinance amending the comprehensive plan future land use map of the city to reflect the land use designation of residential for a parcel of property located at 3037 West 30th Court, Panama City, Florida, providing for repealer, severability, and effective date.
Item 7F is the final reading of Ordinance 3000.3, amending the zoning map of the city to reflect a zoning designation of residential 1, R1, for the property located at 3037 West 30th Court in Panama City, Florida. As background information, it's the same as I shared during the annexation amendment agenda request, and the recommendation is to conduct the final reading of the ordinance.
Anyone want to address us on the zoning change? Hear a motion on Ordinance 3000.3.
Make the motion.
Second the motion, Mayor.
Discussion? Call the roll.
Commissioner Street?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Mayor Brunecki?
Yes.
Commission has adopted ordinance 3000.3, an ordinance zoning a parcel of property located at 3037 West 30th Court, Panama City, Florida, having approximately 0.526 acres, R1, providing for severability and effective date.
Item 7G is the final reading of ordinance 3002.1, amending the future land use map of the city to reflect a land use designation of mixed use for the property located at 700 East 10th Street in Panama City, Florida. The applicant wishes to build houses on this property. The planning board considered this item at its regularly scheduled meeting on May 10th, 2021. The motion was made to recommend approval, and the board members voted unanimously to make this recommendation. As such, it's the recommendation that we conduct the final reading of the ordinance.
Your motion?
Yes, I'd like to move approval of item 7G.
This is a public hearing.
Right,
I'm sorry.
That's right. I was trying to relocate my carpet here. Yeah, I'm here to make that motion.
All right.
I just made it, Commissioner Brown.
All right, got a motion and a second. Anyone like to address us on this issue? Call the roll.
Commissioner Street?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Mayor Bernicke?
Yes.
Commission has adopted ordinance 3002.1. An ordinance amending the comprehensive plan future land use map of the city to reflect the land use designation of mixed use for parcels of property located at 700 East 10th Street, Panama City, providing for repealer, severability, and effective date.
Item 7H is the final reading of ordinance 3002.2, amending the zoning map of the city to reflect a zoning designation of mixed use 3, MU3, for the property located at 700 East 10th Street, Panama City, Florida. As background information, it's the same information as I shared in the future land use amendment agenda request, and the recommendation is to conduct the final reading of the ordinance.
Continuing the public hearing, anyone want to address us? Seeing no one, to hear a motion on 3002.2?
Yes, Mr. Mayor, a motion to approve.
I'll second Commissioner Brown's motion.
Any other discussion? Call the roll.
Commissioner Street?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes, ma'am.
Mayor Bernicke?
Yes.
Commission has adopted ordinance 3002.2, an ordinance zoning parcels of property located at 700 East 10th Street, having approximately 0.111 acres, mixed use 3, providing for severability and effective date.
Item 7I is the final reading of ordinance 3003.1, amending the future land use map of the city to reflect a land use designation of industry for the property located at 1311 Redwood Avenue in Panama City, Florida. As background information, the applicant has requested a rezoning to meet the city's code for industrial businesses. The planning board considered this item at its regularly scheduled meeting on May 10th, 2021, and the motion was made to recommend approval, and that recommendation was done so unanimously. As a result, the recommendation is we conduct the final reading of the ordinance.
Anyone here like to address us on this issue? Go ahead.
I know
that. Gotta come up to the mic.
Yes, I would like to address that. That is the land right down in the bottom of the hill.
Name and address.
720 Kirkland Avenue. My name is Edward Bell.
Thank you, sir.
That's the land right down below Picking Pool. I'm just requesting, I'm asking what type of stuff is going to be placed there. I noticed when you dredged Cargray Park for the boat ramp, some of that debris was brought over there. I noticed that a lot of debris was burnt down there. There's a water stream runs down at the bottom of that hill that goes all through Millville, Glenwood, and all of that. And, you know, I remember on the 16th Street project, you made that park over there a place, but what type of heavy industrial waste is going to be put there in that general location in the bottom of that hill? And if it's going to be any type of stuff that's going to be DEP prohibited, no, let us know. Thank you.
No, we wouldn't do that. Commissioner, for the record, Mike Lane, planning director. This is actually the Picking Pool site.
Pick and pull, right?
It is the Picking Pool.
Yeah, the interesting thing is that when we were looking at the map, the Picking Pool guys were interested in trying to do some activity on that site, and we recognized that it was general commercial 2, which is not an industrial type category. So we recognized that we needed to rezone the property in order for them to continue to do the type of activity that Picking Pool previously had. So that's actually what's before you at this point.
Thank you.
Okay. Did that help you?
Yeah.
Yep. Okay.
Yep. All right. Your motion?
Yes, I'd like to move approval.
Okay.
I'll second the motion.
Any other discussion? Call the roll.
Commissioner Street?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes, ma'am.
Mayor Bernicki?
Yes.
Commission has adopted Ordinance 3003.1, an ordinance amending the comprehensive plan future land use map of the city to reflect a land use designation of industry for a parcel of property located at 1311 Redwood Avenue, Panama City, providing for repealer, severability, and effective date.
Item 7J is a final reading of Ordinance 3003.2, amending the zoning map of the city to reflect a zoning designation of heavy industrial, HI, for the property located at 1311 Redwood Avenue, Panama City, Florida. As background information, it's the same as I shared in the future land use amendment agenda request, and the recommendation is to conduct the final reading of the ordinance.
Hear motion on 3003.2?
Yes, Mayor. I'd like to make a motion for approval.
Hear second?
Yes, I'll second the motion.
Discussion? Call roll.
Commissioner Street?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Mayor Bernicki?
Yes.
Commission has adopted Ordinance Number 3003.2, an ordinance zoning a parcel of property located at 1311 Redwood Avenue, Panama City, Florida, having approximately 10 acres, heavy industry, providing for severability and an effective date.
Item 7K is the final reading of Ordinance 3004.1, amending the future land use map of the city to reflect a land use designation of mixed use for the property located at 1106 Oak Avenue in Panama City, Florida. As background information, the applicant wishes to redevelop the property from the single-family residence use towards a multifamily use through a triplex or a quadplex. The Planning Board considered this item at its regularly scheduled meeting on May 10th, 2021. A motion was made to recommend approval, and the board members voted unanimously to make that recommendation, and as such, it's the recommendation we move forward with conducting the final reading of the ordinance.
This is a public hearing. Anyone like to address us on 1106? Hope? Seeing no one, hear a motion?
Yes, I'd like to move approval, Mr. Mayor.
Second the motion, Mayor.
Any other discussion? Call the roll.
Commissioner Street?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Mayor Bernicki?
Yes.
Commission has adopted Ordinance Number 3004.1, an ordinance amending the comprehensive plan future land use map of the city to reflect a land use designation of mixed use for parcels of property located at 1106 Oak Avenue, Panama City, providing for repealer, severability, and effective date.
Item 7L is the final reading of Ordinance 3004.2, amending the zoning map of the city to reflect a zoning designation of mixed use 3, MU3, for the property located at 1106 Oak Avenue in Panama City, Florida. As background information, it's the same as I shared during the future land use amendment agenda request, and the recommendation is that we conduct the final reading of the ordinance.
Your motion on 3004.2?
Yes, I'll move approval, Mayor.
Second the motion, Mayor.
Any other discussion? Call the roll.
Commissioner Street?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Mayor Bernicki?
Yes.
Commission has adopted Ordinance 3004.2, an ordinance zoning parcels of property located at 1106 Oak Avenue, Panama City, Florida, having approximately 0.321 acres, mixed use 3, providing for severability and effective date.
Item 7M is the final reading of Ordinance 3005.1, amending the future land use map of the city to reflect a land use designation of general commercial for the property located at 625 West Baldwin Road in Panama City, Florida. As background information, the applicant has requested rezoning for an expansion to the facility and an increased parking lot level of service. The Planning Board considered this item at its regularly scheduled meeting on May 10th, 2021, and the motion was made to recommend approval, and that was done so unanimously. As such, it's the recommendation that we conduct the final reading of the ordinance.
This is a public hearing. If anyone would like to address us on this issue, seeing no one, do I hear a motion on Ordinance 3005.1?
Yes, Mayor, I'd like to move approval of Ordinance 3005.1.
Second the motion.
Discussion? Call the roll.
Commissioner Street?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Mayor Bernicki?
Yes.
Commission has approved Ordinance 3005.1,
An ordinance amending the comprehensive plan future land use map of the city reflect a land use designation of general commercial for a parcel of property located at 625 West Baldwin Road, providing for repealer, severability, and effective date.
Item 7N is the final reading of ordinance 3005.2, amending the zoning map of the city to reflect a zoning designation of General Commercial 2, GC2, for the property located at 625 West Baldwin Road in Panama City, Florida. His background information is the same as I shared during the future land use amendment agenda request, and the recommendation is that we conduct the final reading of the ordinance.
This is a public hearing. Anyone like to address us on this issue? Hear motion on 3005.2.
I'd like to move approval of it, Mayor.
Second the motion, Mayor.
Discussion? Call the roll.
Commissioner Street?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Mayor Brunick?
Yes, ma'am.
Commission has adopted ordinance 3005.2, an ordinance zoning a parcel of property located at 625 West Baldwin Road, having approximately 2.7 acres, GC2, providing for severability and effective date.
Item 7O is the final reading of ordinance 3006.1, amending the future land use map of the city to reflect a land use designation of urban residential for the property located at 1409 Frankfort Avenue in Panama City, Florida. As background information, the applicant would like to develop 12 residential units, and the planning board considered this item at its regularly scheduled meeting on May 10th, 2021. A motion was made to deny the approval, and the board members voted unanimously to deny that approval. As such, it's for your consideration for the final reading of the ordinance.
Okay, this is a public hearing. Anyone like to address us on the issue?
Good morning, Mayor and members of the commission. My name is Michelle Castillo, and I am here today with my partner, Luz Duoday. We are a certified general contractor for the state of Florida, and are requesting for this rezoning, it, obviously depending on the density that is allowed to be able to build additional units. Since October, since we've been here in Panama City, we've invested close to $1 million of our own money into Panama City, into developing new properties and rehabbing a specific property that we just completed and got a CO last week. We started the construction in February. It's the property that's located on 3533 Highway 98. Commissioner Street joined us that day. I wasn't present, but you were there with Augusto, and thank you for that. We appreciate it. And in a short 4 months, we were able to get that 14-unit building rehabbed and give a home to several people that were in need of a roof. Augusto will come up and speak briefly additionally on some other things that we want to do with this property and another one that's on the agenda as well. And we proposed about 12 units, but we're not sure that that's what's able to be done based on the density of that and the drainage, which will also, you know, be dependent on what the city members agree to based on drainage, setbacks, and so forth. Before I finish, I wanted to give a special thank you because I think it's very important to show appreciation for, there's so many to name, but just in general, Mike Lane, Steven Stanford, Patty Sunday, they've been very helpful to us since we arrived in Panama City in October and have made this very streamlined for us to be able to move in the right direction and get our rehabs done as quick as possible. So we look forward to doing many more things here in Panama City, and thank you for your time.
Anyone else like to address us on this issue?
I'll go ahead and say, you know, I got to see their project here, one over off of 98, and so obviously very good developer, builder, great heart for the community. So happy to have you guys here. I did have some conversations with residents regarding this particular one, and the concern is the density, and so. What I would encourage, and this is just from my opinion, it's in Ward 4, everyone has their own. I would encourage us to relook at that and come up with maybe a better density that would work with the neighbors adjacent. And so I don't think that there is a desire to prevent this, and I definitely don't want to slow you guys down. I think you guys are doing great work already. I just think it might be better. And one, obviously, I don't know that we make it a habit of going against a unanimous decision at the planning board, but that's just my feedback. So.
Okay. So the recommendation is to deny from the planning board, so they can go back to the drawing board afterwards if we do vote to do that. So do I hear a motion that we vote to deny?
I'll make that motion.
Okay. Do I hear a second?
Second motion, Mayor.
Any other discussion? Call the roll.
Commissioner Street?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Mayor Brennick?
Yes.
Okay, the ordinance was not passed, and that moots the first reading.
Final reading. The final reading.
The final reading, yes, of 7P, which is for zoning.
So 7P is deleted from the
7P
agenda?
7P is no action taken because the comprehensive plan was not changed.
Yes, sir. Thank you. So with that, I draw your attention to item 7Q, which is the final reading of ordinance 3007.1, amending the future land use map of the city to reflect a land use designation of urban residential for the property located at 1805 Laurel Avenue and 1808 Mound Avenue within Panama City, Florida. The applicant wishes to develop more dense residential use on this property, and the planning board considered this item at its regularly scheduled meeting on May 10th, 2021. The motion was made to recommend approval, and that vote was 4-1 in support of the approval for that. As such, it's the recommendation to conduct the final reading of the ordinance.
This is a public hearing. Anyone like to address us on this issue? Seeing no one, do I hear a motion on 3007.1?
Yes, Mayor, I'd like to move approval of 3007.1.
I'll second.
Any other discussion?
Second motion, Mayor.
Call the roll.
Commissioner Street?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Mayor Brennick?
Yes.
The commission has adopted ordinance 3007.1, an ordinance amending the comprehensive plan future land use map of the city to reflect a land use designation of urban residential for a parcel of property located at 1808 Mound Avenue in Panama and 1805 Laurel Avenue, Panama City, Florida, providing for repealer, severability, and effective date.
Item 7R is the final reading of ordinance 3007.2, amending the zoning map of the city to reflect a zoning designation of urban residential 2, UR2, for the property located at 1805 Laurel Avenue and 1808 Mound Avenue within Panama City, Florida. His background information is the same as I shared during the future land use amendment agenda request, and the recommendation is to conduct the final reading of the ordinance.
Continuing the public hearing, anyone like to address us? Seeing no one, to hear a motion on ordinance 3007.2.
So moved, Mayor.
Second motion, Mayor.
Any other discussion? Call the roll.
Commissioner Street?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Mayor Brennick?
Yes.
Commission has adopted ordinance 3007.2 and ordinance zoning a parcel of property located at 1808 Mound Avenue and 1805 Laurel Avenue, Panama City, having approximately 0.456 acres, urban residential 2, providing for severability and effective date.
Four items on the consent agenda. Your motion on the consent agenda?
I'll make the motion.
I second it, Mr. Mayor.
Any other discussion? Call the roll.
Commissioner Street?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Mayor Brennicki?
Yes.
Mr. Mayor and Commissioners, I draw your attention to item 9A, which is the consideration to extend the current continuing services contracts that's in place within the city of Panama City. As background information, the city currently has contracts with 22 engineering, geotechnical, architectural, and environmental consulting firms that were selected in May 2017 through a request for qualifications in accordance with Florida, Florida Consultant Competitive Negotiations Act to be available for the execution of task orders for discrete scopes of work to assist the city on various projects. As if the study is less than $500,000 and the construction costs are less than $4 million, then the city may assign any consultant under the contract with the city to perform the professional services.
The original term of the contracts ended on June 26, 2020, and the first one-year extension will end on June 26, 2021. The original contract provides for 2 one-year extensions. Since it has been more than 4 years since the city requested qualifications from interested consultants for continuing services, and the city is anticipating numerous construction projects and studies, the city staff would like to advertise a new request for qualifications in July of 2021 to attract and add more consultants with the continuing consultants contracts. The staff recommends this is to extend the current contracts until September 30th, 2021, and then advertise a request for qualifications in order to attract more consultants. As such, it's the recommendation that we move forward with extending under the second one-year extension with the required 30 days notice that this extension will end on September 30th, 2021.
Your motion?
Yes, Mr. Mayor, I'd like to make a motion for approval.
I'll second the motion.
Any other discussion? Call the roll.
Commissioner Street?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Mayor Bernicke?
Yes.
Item 9B is consideration to award bid number PC21-021 for Harrison Avenue Reconstruction Segment 1, known as Streetscapes, to Royal American Construction Incorporated for the sum of $7,269,014. As background information, the City of Panama City received a single bid for the reconstruction of Harrison Avenue from Government Street to 4th Street and reconstruction on the side streets to include Government Street, Beach Drive, Oak Avenue, and 4th Street. The major items of work involve mobilization, clearing and grubbing, erosion and control, maintenance of traffic, earthwork, stabilization, base asphalt for bicycle lanes, curb, gutter, stormwater replacement, soil cells, landscaping, irrigation, hardscaping, lighting, conduit, signing, pavers for the replacement of the roadway, as well as crosswalks and sidewalks. The staff recommends that we move forward with the award of the bid submitted by Royal American Construction, as only one bid was submitted. The total of 8 companies, GAC, HPE Incorporated, Phoenix Construction, Marshall Brothers, GCUC, Royal American, DAG Architects, L&R Contracting, all attended the pre-bid conference, but only one was submitted, and that was from Royal American Construction. As such, it's our recommendation to move forward with the award of this contract to Royal American Construction for the streetscape on Harrison Avenue in the amount of $7,269,014.
Long time coming, trying to do something.
I was going to say the same thing. There's been a long time coming.
Yeah, you want to come forward?
Well, PNC 14 Maple Avenue. I just wondering, is any sewer work going to be done? Because I know y'all done put some new water lines in there already on Harrison Avenue. Now, during this construction, I don't know, did you say sewer was going to be changed out? I just want to know what.
As well as stormwater as well.
Stormwater as well. All right. But we are, that's wonderful. But how folks going to get around the city? Because y'all will probably end up closing whole Harrison Avenue.
No, sir. It'll be done block by block as we move north on Harrison.
All right, understand that too. But when the sewer's in the middle of the street, how you gonna work that out?
The sewers a few years ago when you were still working here, you just have to do it in sections. It's a bear. But
I understand that, Mayor. Yeah. I understand that, what you're saying. But when the sewer is in the middle of the street, either the storm drain is on the, if the storm drain's on the side, it's fine. But when it's in the middle of the street, this whole street ought to be shut down. Let y'all go figure a way, because they got to put their junk, they dig up somewhere, unless they putting it on trucks, putting trucks there, then you got truck traffic and everybody else. I'm just saying, y'all need to think about it. It's a good project. Nothing wrong with the project, but I'm saying you're going to be cutting down businesses. And you'll be cutting down folks' transportation going down the street, if they can get down the street. You know, I knew it sounded to be easy, but it's not as easy as y'all saying and that y'all thinking to do it.
It's something that has to be done, though. And I think maybe if it's really bad, then they may consider doing some of it at night. I don't know.
It's going to have
to. It has to be done.
Part of the roads are going to be closed. Yeah. There's nothing you can do about it.
Mr. Henry, there's in the plan, there's a rediversion of traffic that the contractor's committing to do, as well as access to the businesses. So they have done a thorough evaluation of how to accomplish that. And I do have quite a few questions on this project, because I'm coming in, obviously, you guys have been working on this a long time, I think since 2016, 2015, so 6 years. But I did want to ask, what was the staff's original estimate of this project?
Yeah, we assessed that the original project would be in the neighborhood of $4 to $5 million.
Of $4 to $5 million, and so we're coming out at
7.2.
That's a pretty big jump.
It's called inflation.
I think that estimate is pretty recent, though, that the staff came up with that. I also think that the item that we just approved, if it was 4 to 5, I think that there was maybe a few missteps on the engineering as far as how we procured that. Am I correct with that? Because of item 9A?
We did not have that estimate until after the engineering was done. The engineering was not expected. When we initially contracted for the engineering, it was not expected that it would be that much based on historical pricing of roadways within the city of Panama City.
Okay, so we've increased the price now twice. So when we initially engaged with the engineering, we thought it was going to be less than $4 million.
Yes.
Okay. So City of Lynn Haven had a similar issue to this same scenario. There was a ball field, came out, one bid, came back to project, I think it was about $6 million. They went back out to bid, advertised regionally, and broke it up into segments. The project came out to about 3.5. And so I think this project is so complex that has a lot to do with why we're not seeing as much engagement here. And so I love the project. I mean, I think the project's great. I don't even necessarily think there needs to be re-engineering or anything value engineering to it. I think that this bid structure, the way that it was done, I think that's what led us to the point that we're at now. Mark, do you know exactly where we advertised this?
We advertised this through a number of ways. One is through our push system that mm-hmm. for all registered contractors that have historically registered okay. for notifications. We also notify or place it on the city's website as a standard protocol. And then the third location, Johnny or Jonathan?
Was that the local newspaper?
The local newspaper.
Right. So I think we could benefit if we go back out and maybe break this project up a little bit and potentially grow more regionally, because I mean, it's a beautiful project. But you know, like for me, a $7.2 million project for less than a quarter of a mile, that's a lot to stomach on a single bid. I mean, that's my opinion. I know I'm coming in late to the game. I don't want to, you know, kick the can down the field, but at the same time, I do want to be fiscally responsible with taxpayer dollars. And this one is a big, big number.
Comments?
Well, obviously, there's only one company that really wanted to bid on it, that submitted a bid.
Well, I mean,
let's be honest.
But we really don't know all the extenuating circumstances. We do know that everybody is busy right now. Everybody's looking for contractors.
Yeah.
And that the prices of all the things that we are, you know, getting done, a sheet of plywood was $3.5 and now it's 14. So, you know, the cost of construction has gone nuts, and it's been 6 or 7 years, and I guess in that amount of time, getting down to the nuts and bolts, I mean, I think when we were looking at $4 or $5 million on this, it was wishful thinking. I mean, we were hoping.
Well, I believe it originally started, Mr. Mayor. I think originally started at 2.6. This is a completely new engineered project from what you guys even started with,
right.
And so. I mean, that's just my take. I mean, obviously, we govern as a panel.
Not anticipated, Josh. With all due respect,
when they originally started it, there were some things that were overlooked. I can't pinpoint what they were. And I understand, I'm the first person that wants to save every dollar we can. I respect that. I want to do the same thing. But I just hate, my goodness, we've come so far. We have come so far with this. So many charrettes. People have come all to so many different things. Meeting after meeting after meeting. People following and walking downtown and looking. And with the prices continuing to escalate, I don't see how you're going to get done any cheaper.
We've advertised it the way we're supposed to advertise it. I don't know.
It's just, prices are crazy.
Well, again, love the project. The procurement is really where my issue stands with it.
Okay. Well, do we hear a motion that we...
Yes, Mr. Mayor. I would like to make a motion to approve.
Okay.
You're second?
Yes, I'll second the motion.
Okay. Any other discussion? Call the roll.
Commissioner Street?
No.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Mayor Bernicke?
Yes.
Okay, moving on to item 9C, which is consideration to award bid PC21-24 for the Panama City Fleet Vehicle Preventive Maintenance Inspection to Bill Kramer Chevrolet, Buick, and GMC. As background information, the City of Panama City determined to request bids to provide preventative maintenance and oil changes for approximately 200 Panama City fleet vehicles for the next 18 to 24 months until the city has reconstructed its own vehicle maintenance shop that was destroyed by Hurricane Michael. The city staff received a single bid on April 21st, 2021 from Bill Kramer Chevrolet Buick GMC, also known as Kramer Automobile Dealership. That is estimated cost would be $71,960 annually. And the city staff mistakenly thought it had the authority to reject the bid due to the fact it was a single bid. An identical request for bids was then advertised, and this time the city received a single bid from Expert Auto and Ace Repair LLC on May 28, 2021, Expert Auto, and that it was significantly higher than the Kramer bid in that it was estimated to be $127,992 annually. The city attorney's office reviewed the bids and determined that since the total anticipated amount of the Kramer contract was more than the purchasing authority of the city manager, that only the city commission and not city staff could reject the Kramer bid. Kramers were contacted and they're willing to honor their bid as submitted. Further, since the Kramer bid was not rejected by the commission, then there was no basis for the advertising of the second identical request for bids. As such, staff is recommending that we move forward with awarding the bid to Bill Kramer Chevrolet Buick GMC and authorize notice to Expert Auto that its bid was not accepted.
Your motion?
Yes, Mr. Mayor, I'd like to to make a motion to approve.
Your second?
I'll second.
Any other discussion? Call the roll.
Commissioner Street?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Mayor Bernicke?
Yes.
Item 9D is a consideration to approve award of bid PC21-32 for the McKenzie House lead abatement to Hull's Environmental Services for the sum of $129,420. As background information, the City of Panama City received two bids to perform the lead paint removal on all elevations of the McKenzie House located in downtown Panama City. This will be the lead abatement removal as well as repainting the building. Such as our recommendation that we move forward with the award of PC21-32 to Hull Environmental Services.
Your motion on 9D?
Yes, Mr. Mayor, I'd like to make a motion to approve a staff's recommendation.
Your second?
Second to motion.
Any discussion? Call the roll.
Commissioner Street?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Mayor Bradnicki?
Yes.
Item 9E is a consideration to award bid PC21-33 for Lindenwood Drive roadway improvement to American Sand and Asphalt in the amount of $4,400,000 and approve the accompanying budget amendment resolution 2021-06-22.5. As background information, the Lindenwood Drive improvements project consists of reconstructing the existing road, the drainage, the infrastructure, water and sewer utilities for Lindenwood Drive, which is approximately 2,250 linear feet. In general, the roadway and all utility infrastructure will be placed in the same location as is existing. The storm drain infrastructure will be replaced and upgraded and connecting it to the existing systems at the right-of-way. As such, it's a staff recommendation that we award the bid to American Sand and Asphalt, as only one bid was submitted. A total of three companies, ASAP, LNR Contracting, and CWR, as well as American Sand and Asphalt, all were at the pre-bid meeting, and only one qualified bid was submitted for consideration. As such, it's our recommendation that we move forward and award the PC 21-33 to American Sand and Asphalt in the amount of $4.4 million.
All right, Billy, go ahead.
Yeah, thank you, sir. I've been waiting a long, long time on this one.
Figure you're going to get a wahoo or something.
Yeah. Woohoo, yeah. Move approval. Move approval.
Well, I do want to ask a couple questions first.
Who are you asking them to? Who are you asking them to?
Mark, what was the first staff estimate on this project?
When we first looked at this project, we thought it would be in the $2.5 to $3 million range.
Okay. And so we're at 4.4. That's another almost double where we were. How was this one advertised?
The same way.
All right. My comments are the same. We've got a procurement issue. This one, though, I do understand, Commissioner Rader. This one's been a long time coming. My in-laws actually lived on this road. They do not anymore, so there's no conflict of interest here. But it's been a really, really long road for these people. I can understand what, but I see we've designated the surtax loan funds. We're at about $10 million that were coming out of surtax loan funds. How much do we have left? Mr. McQueen, do you know?
We had an original loan of $15 million. And Brandy, do you?
We've spent some on design work. Right. Okay. And so with these, there's around $14 million left. And then
With these. So this is, I just want to draw our attention to, because it's not so much about this one here or this project or where we're going. I think that we've got a bigger issue that we need to resolve, because this is less than 3/4 of a mile that we have almost spent 3/4 of all of our surtax dollars that we've collected over the last 4 years. This is not, I'm all for raising the bar of excellence in the city, but I don't want to set a new precedence that not only it doesn't just affect us, it affects every municipality. So if people think that less than a half a mile of road now costs $4.4 million, well, that's going to hurt every municipality, not just us. And so I understand this one is an important project. I don't want to kick it down the can. That it's been way before the hurricane. But I think that there's some work that you're doing behind the scenes, potentially, Mr. Queen, on improving procurement. Is that correct? I would love for that to get to our agenda as soon as possible, just so that we can prevent more single bids and actually getting the best value.
So I would thank you for that comment. We are following the city's procurement policy as written that was approved by this commission exactly. To the point that you're alluding to, which is expanding and casting the net wider, that's absolutely an intent that will be integrated into the new policy that will become procurement policy that will be coming before the City Commission, as well as other things that will help to streamline the procurement policies for the city. They're, in my estimation, fairly antiquated and have put a stranglehold on the city's ability to move forward. With that in mind, neither of these projects were bid under the local preference. It was open to anybody that would be publicly noticed. Don't disagree with the fact that putting it out there in the public domain as widely as possible is our objective, and we will see what takes place. I think the other thing is, amplifying on the mayor's comments, if I may, is that there is a tremendous amount of work that is available for contractors to bid on that is unencumbered work. It's unfettered land that has no intricacies that they have to work around, which adds to the level of complexity to these projects. So we're in a very difficult situation within the city, as well as the other municipalities, as you alluded to, and the county, that are all facing this same type of issue with regard to shortage of contractors available to do the type of work that we're asking for.
From a common sense standpoint, who's going to mobilize all the equipment that it takes to do a road, to do 2,200 feet and come from out of town? I mean, a $4 million project, it's a lot of money, but for a road, that's very, very small and short. I mean, that's the problem you got. I mean, they're going to come in there and be doing miles and miles of stuff, but for something that size, that's probably why we've got the bid that we got. And like I say, we're not using a local preference on it, but it's just not that advantageous for somebody to come from Pensacola or somewhere else to do a project that size. So
it's true.
Go ahead, Mr. Henry.
I made a motion. We haven't had a chance for a second yet. But whatever.
All right, we got a motion.
We can still discuss.
Yes. I'd like to make the motion that we'll.
No, I made the motion.
Okay, you made the motion.
We just need a second then. Okay, right. I like the second.
That's all I'm saying.
Okay, any other discussion?
No, we can discuss, yes.
Long dialogue.
Walter P. Henry, 614 Maple Avenue. And we looked at lining these lines, checked on it, see how lining is on some of these lines that we're talking the whole city, really. Just putting a lining in them. Somebody checked it, cameraed it, looked up, see how bad these lines are. And somebody could go inside of each line, pull this sand out of them, look at the joints. And these joints could be sealed from the inside. Companies do this. I don't know if they don't quit, but I just wanted to have y'all look at lining them. You don't have to you can line the main, you can line the service line as well without tearing, I knew going to tear the street up to do some things, but keep from having everybody just wondering how they're going to get into their property. They're going to be able to get into their property. I'm just asking you, have y'all looked at this? Have y'all thought about this? I know manholes.
Fix the road, Mr.
Manholes are bad. Yeah, but you line them, that should seal the joints. A lining goes in there, blow it up, seal those joints. There's no joint there. There's a joint there, but you don't see it. It's on the outside, inside the sand. But I just wanted to have we looked at that? Have we thought about that? To keep from having so much, volume, that traffic's going and folks trying to get in their houses or get into business and stuff. And I know that folks have businesses. They don't want to lose. They ain't in business to lose money. They're in business to create money. So just like the city, if it was not without us, the citizens of Panama City, the city would not be a city. You can might as well to just crumb it up and set it to be a ghost town. So I'm just asking y'all this. I know some of you will do what you want to do, but have we looked into it?
In the fall of 2019, we did something that was unprecedented that I've never been a part of, and I'm very proud we did it. Our city manager took the time, and our Mr. Johnny Sims, everybody took the time. We invited every citizen on Lindenwood, every citizen, and this room was a lot of people in this room, and we had just those citizens only. Myself, I was here with the staff, and we did a complete slide presentation, and we gave the citizens the choice of whether they wanted sidewalks, bicycle lanes, trees, additional trees, or just the straight ahead road improved with new infrastructure because the road is sinking. And unanimously, every citizen pitched a fit and said, we don't want sidewalks, this is what we want, and we understand we're gonna be it's gonna be a hindrance to us. But we won't. So we have addressed that. You need to know that. We have addressed that. I'm just talking.
Okay.
I want you to know, 2019 in the fall, we had an open meeting here and addressed that. Same thing you're talking about. And that's all I'm trying to say. We did our work before today, with all due respect.
I think.
Mr. Henry,
I don't live in Lindenwood. I mean, she was questioning me, Mayor, And my is, when somebody questioning you, you stand and let them talk.
He wasn't questioning you. He was just saying we
did it.
We had the public involved.
We did that.
We did exactly what you said.
Correct. I'm not saying that.
Okay.
I'm not saying that, but you hadn't asked the question. I'm not going to have, we thought about it, doing these things. Is it going to cost us more money? Which one is going to be cheaper, to dig them up or line them? That's all I'm saying to you.
Well, I thought you were talking about people being able to get through.
It will help folks to get through, because you ain't going to have that much. You got, when you dig up a line, you're removing current asphalt. Sometimes you got some lines that, like down on 4th Street, you dig that line up, you have concrete and asphalt. It's up underneath there. You don't see that concrete, but it's concrete up on the Harrison Avenue.
Thank you, Mr. Henry.
So that's what I'm asking. Which one is cheaper? Digging and tearing the ground, and putting in a sewer line. You can't do a water line. You got to dig a water line up to replace it. Mm-hmm. But you can take it and reestablish it, put it in a different spot like that. You can change it where it's set. But that's all I'm asking you. I'm not.
We will, thank you.
I'm not saying you're not doing what you are. I'm just telling you, which is cheaper.
All right.
So also, Mr. Mayor and Commissioners, I want to thank Senator Gaynor and Representative Trumbull, who worked to assist in securing state funding to assist in this project. And the legislature and Governor DeSantis approved it, that $500,000 would be floating through DOT to support this particular project.
Okay, we have a motion and second. Call the roll.
Commissioner Street?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Mayor Brennicki?
Yes.
Item 9F is consideration to award bid PC 21-34 for Sudduth Park improvements.
He's got a resolution to read. Sorry.
Thank you. This is resolution 2021-06-22.5. A resolution providing for the amendment of the approved fiscal year 2021 budget for a DOT grant for Lindenwood Drive roadway improvements. Thank you.
So 9F is consideration to award bid PC 21-34 for the Sudduth Park improvements to Inland Construction and Engineering Incorporated in the amount of $1,347,067. As background information, the Sudduth Park improvement project consists of reconstructing Sudduth Park and includes one new baseball field, parking, a pavilion, fencing, lighting, landscaping, and other associated amenities. The City Commission rejected all the bids that were submitted previously because the bids were considered higher than the budgeted amount. The staff changed the scope of the project to achieve cost savings, and a second request for proposal was submitted for the improvements to Sudduth Park and was advertised on May 3rd, 2021 and May 7th, 2021. The bids were opened publicly on June 2nd, 2021 at 2 p.m. in room 10 of the City Hall, and the staff has determined that the lowest responsive bidder is Inland Construction and Engineering Incorporated, whose bid price was $1,347,067. Winterfield Construction initially had the lowest apparent total lump sum base bid amount of $1,316,527, in other words, $30,540 less than the lowest responsive bidder. However, there was an error in the base bid amount that involves the price. After reasonable inquiry with Winterfield Construction, the city was advised by Mr. Tommy Hamm that the lump sum base bid amount, item A plus B, was correct, but there was an error in line item B23 concerning the price for field lighting poles and the foundations. The total of the base bid amounts exceeds the lump sum base bid amount by $33,000. Winterfell Construction was not the lowest responsive bidder because there was a mistake or irregularity in the base bid amount, and the base bid amounts involve price. According to the bid instructions under section 19.01, and I quote, the owner also reserves the right to waive all minor informalities not involving price, time, or changes to the work. Here, the mistake or informality that we have witnessed involves price and therefore cannot be waived. The city attorney's office has reviewed the bid responses and concurs with the conclusions and recommendation that the bid for Sudeth Park should be awarded to Inland Construction and Engineering Incorporated, whose bid price was $1,347,067. As such, it's my recommendation that we move forward awarding that bid to Inland Construction for the amount that I just shared.
Hear a motion on 9F?
Yes, Mr. Mayor. I would like a motion to approve to accept the department head recommendation.
Hear a second?
I'll second.
Any other discussion? Call the roll.
Commissioner Street?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Mayor Brennicki?
Yes.
Item 9G is the consideration to reject an award of bid PC21-004 for mowing of the right-of-ways, Hurricane Michael, to MNC Lawn Maintenance in the amount of $73,966. As background information, the City of Panama City posted a bid for a single-pass litter removal and mowing within the right-of-way of the city, maintained roads related to Hurricane Michael debris and broken up by wards. The bids were due November 30th, 2020. However, the deadline for FEMA reimbursement for debris removal expired as of December 31st, 2019. There was only one bid that was submitted, and it's recommended that the city formally reject the sole bid due to the lack of a funding source associated with FEMA. As a result, my recommendation is we move forward with rejecting the bid received from MNC Lawn Maintenance.
Motion to reject.
Yes, I move that we reject the bid.
Second the motion, Mayor.
Any other discussion? Call the roll.
Commissioner Street?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Mayor Brennicki?
Yes.
Item 9H is consideration to reject award of a bid PC21-28, Fuel Farm at the Panama City Marina to Inland Construction and Engineering in the amount of $359,265.65. As background information, the City of Panama City received a bid for the construction, both labor and materials, and certification of a temporary fueling station to be located at the Panama City Marina. The sole bid came in over budget. The city will now change the scope of services to utilize the original tanks that were not damaged as previously thought from Hurricane Michael, and we will use the existing docks. As such, it's our recommendation that we move forward with rejecting the bid with Inland Construction and Engineering, and it's the intent of the city to move forward with designing an operational fuel point at the Panama City Marina in the location where it was originally pre-stored.
Motion to reject.
Motion to reject. I make the motion.
Second the motion.
Any other discussion?
I'd just like to point out one more time that this is a single bid. So I just wanted to use that opportunity. Thank you. I'm glad we're rejecting it.
Okay. Call the roll.
Commissioner Street?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Mayor Brennicki?
Yes.
Item 9I is the consideration of approval of the American Rescue Plan Fiscal Recovery Fund's funding objectives and the accompanying budget amendment resolution 2021-0622.1. As background information, the City of Panama City has been allocated $10.1 million in the fiscal recovery funding known as the American Rescue Plan. Half of which was received on May 20th, 2021, and the remainder will be received in 1 year. The coronavirus, state and local fiscal recovery funds provide a substantial infusion of resources to help turn the tide on the pandemic, address its economic fallout, and lay the foundation for a strong and equitable recovery. Proposed funding objectives are as follows in no particular priority. Number one, the reimbursement of costs to the city for expenses to protect the public health. Number two would be to reimburse the city for any revenue shortfalls experienced by the city or any of its agencies. Item three, economic development, promoting businesses and industries that are the strength of our city, which would include the enhancement of tourism, travel, and hospitality sectors within projects that would include such as Snug Harbor, the Lake Huntington Boat Ramp, the Bob George Boat Ramp, the microloan program to shore up existing and stimulate new businesses, communication strategy to promote Panama City as open for business, education and training partnerships for the future workforce needs of the city, and a city restaurant dumpster cleaning program. And the fourth would be the infrastructure improvements specifically addressing water lines, sewer lines, and storm water management, specifically noting Harrison Avenue streetscape, Baker's Court, and stormwater ditches. As such, it's my recommendation that we move forward with the approval of the proposed American Rescue Plan funding objectives and that the accompanying budget amendment resolution be adopted.
Okay, I hear a motion on 9I.
I'd like to move approval of 9I, Mayor.
Second motion, Mayor.
Any other discussion? Call the roll.
Commissioner Street?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Mayor Brennicki?
Yes.
Commission has approved Resolution 2021-0622.1, a resolution providing for the amendment of the approved fiscal year 2021 budget for the American Rescue Plan Fiscal Recovery Funds.
The final item on the agenda is item 9J, which is consideration of approval of the emergency repairs to East Avenue from Nelson Street to Fifth Street by Roberts and Roberts Incorporated in the total amount of $568,992.25. As background information, the city has previously worked with the Port Authority, DOT, and Bay County to provide a funding for the replacement of the bridge on East Avenue over the Watson Bayou and repairs to East Avenue from the bridge to Nelson Street. The reason for these expenditures was to support the Port Authority's new warehouse and port project, considered also known as the new port facility on the east side at the end of East Avenue. The port desires to open the new port facility within the next 30 days and has determined that the condition of the East Avenue from Nelson Street to Fifth Street is also inferior and will not support the dozens of daily trucks that will be arriving and departing from the new port facility. Roberts and Roberts Incorporated has performed the previous work associated with the project, and the pricing of this work is generally consistent with their prior work. Alex King, who is in the audience, and thank you, sir, for being here, is our new port director, has indicated that the Port Authority would contribute up to $250,000 toward the cost of this road improvement project, but asked that the work be performed prior to the opening of the new port facility. Both the Port Authority and the city staff are concerned that the road improvement project is not, if not completed, prior to the opening, that the damage to the road would be severe and result in more costly repairs. Emergency exists that there is insufficient time to bid out the project to have the improved East Avenue completed prior to the opening of the new port. We're grateful to the contribution of the Port Panama City to contribute to this project. The recommendation is that we accept the offer of $250,000 from the Port Authority and approve the city contribution of $318,992.25. And declaring the emergency and awarding the paving contract attached to Roberts and Roberts Incorporated. The total amount of that contract is $568,992.25.
Your motion?
Motion of approval, Mayor.
Second?
I'll second.
Any other discussion? Call the roll.
Commissioner Street?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Mayor Brennicki?
Yes. Okay, there isn't anything else to come before us. We are adjourned. Thank you for being here. We'll have CRA give us about 10 minutes.